10 seconds to go. Radiant man.
Hello and welcome back, guys. It's Chicago Ted coming to you with Sudamerican Master 4. Tonight, Radiant's it is Pain back. Gaming taking on Not Today. Not Today having won the first match in this best of three series leaves Pain Gaming to fight for their lives. Well, not really. They're not facing elimination tonight, but it puts them one step closer to being out of the money and out of the tournament, and puts Not Today into the winner's bracket finals, a place where everyone wants to be. So, without further ado, the draft is well underway. Not Today, they might get their revenge here, but regardless of that, I'm being joined by Android. How you doing?
Hey, I'm doing pretty good. Excited for this series. Game one was a lot of fun, and I really want Pain to take this game so we can be forced to a game three where it all gets decided who moves on, who drops down to the lower bracket, because these teams are pretty evenly matched.
Someone's dropped out. Yeah, dropping, I mean, at this point in the draft, every single team is a tough one to go up against, and I'd quickly show it if we weren't well underway of the draft. I mean, in the brackets, why'd I say the draft? But the loser of this game has to go on and face Generation X. Now, Generation X has put on a very strong showing on this tournament. They knocked out Balrogs out of the tournament. So, I mean, you go against that team. Some people haven't heard of them. Some people have. But it's still a struggling, a match that you can struggle in. And in an elimination bracket, anything can happen. So you really don't want to risk that by dropping down at this point. And Not Today are threatening to kick Pain Gaming to that position. It's really troublesome to be in this spot if you're Pain. They've got to pull their minds together, really come through on this draft and at the start of this game just to make sure they don't get that early game hit. That, oh my god.
This is what early game hit. First pick Skyrath Mage, I'm so freaking happy.
Dire pick.
It's okay if you want
to
mute me from now on. Okay, I really love Skyrath. It's most likely going to be a Jericho Skyrath Mage. He's the only one that I've seen run it this patch ever. But I am so happy. I'm going to go tweet this.
Not Today is probably the only team I've seen run a Skyrath Mage. They won with it, actually, last time they played it. I didn't actually get their draft down from that game. But
10 seconds to go.
It's at that point, I mean, Skyrath has his moments where he's a pretty decent early game harassing support. He also has his drawbacks where he can get blown up quickly and easily. Pain Gaming, having the IO, they are kind of forcing Not Today to ban out the Tiny. I imagine we might see an Ursa ban as well. But there are so many things they can do with this IO, and they have run the IO bristle back before. In fact, Pain Gaming have run the Isle Bristle back as well, so they might be first-hand knowledgeable about the struggles of going up against this ball of light.
All right, so Not Today. You can tell that I already love their lineup, so to complement the Skyrath Mage, what do you really pick as a secondary support here? You want someone with a little more survivability, maybe a point-click stun. Would it be so crazy to think an Ogre Magi could be great here?
Ogre Magi wouldn't be that bad, I think. I mean, he's pretty good at blowing up the IO. I think the one thing Ogre Magi has is he doesn't exactly lock anyone down easily. I mean, the Fire Blast is great, but early game, it's kind of like Magic Missile. It doesn't quite have that long of a stun, and it's hard to get off. It's a low-range stun. It's not great to have. Plus, he's a melee support, so harassing's very tough for him. I think Ogre Magi has his issues. If you combine the slows of Skyrath and Ogre, then maybe it's good. But I'm not entirely sure that's what they need to have. I would think more someone with a little bit more crowd control, with a little bit more stun. I would like to see maybe a Witch Doctor or a Lion, someone who fills the role a little bit more solid as a support and can start to make the rotations happen and offer a lot of stun for the Not Today lineup.
Yeah, I mean, Vengeful Spirit is also a pick that comes to mind. She's so contested just because she's really all around a great support. Reasonable survivability. She's got that right-click stun like we want. Winter Wyvern picked up Profane. I think that's a little bit quirky. Winter Wyvern has fallen out of favor due to the Oracle doing a similar thing in terms of keeping the carries alive in the team fights. Pain Gaming going with an Io and a Wyvern. really focusing their supports on regen and keeping everyone healthy, they don't have a lot of roaming potential.
Yes and no. The Winter Wyvern will offer a lot of slow with the
10
Arctic Burn.
seconds
The
to
Iowa
go.
with the relocate gives them a little bit of map control. I think, yeah, early game,
5
early
seconds.
laning, they won't have the greatest rotations coming out, but they do have fantastic saves.
Reserve
So
time.
Winter Wyvern, if he holds on to his TP, can TP into the mid lane and get a cold embrace off, and then all of a sudden your mid laner is fine for the time being. That is until Skywrath Mage starts becoming a problem and you end up putting them in the same spot to open them up to a whole lot of magical burst. Ancient
Dire's
Apparition's
Bane.
a funny one because while Cold Embrace can heal, Ice can also hurt. And Ancient Apparition puts the Ice Blast on, even a Cold Embrace can't help you. So the AA will be a very nice support here to have to go against the Winter Wyvern and the IO. The only thing that AA lacks is that crowd control we were talking about. And considering that's what Not Today are
10
lacking
seconds to
quite a bit,
go.
they either pick up a heavy crowd control hero and their last pick. Maybe they go for
Five
a
seconds.
Beastmaster, maybe they go for a Faceless Void. But whichever one, they need someone
Reserve time.
to lock Pain Gaming down, or they're going to have a lot of trouble at doing anything in the team fight. Skywrath Mage is going to get run on, Juggernaut's going to get kited, Prophet's going to, well, get run on as well. Same with AA. And all Pain Gaming would have to do is maybe pick up a Slark who wouldn't do all that bad with the IO, but just someone who can get up close and personal to the enemy and not fear the repercussions of a stun because Not Today don't have any right now.
I'm worried that Not Today are going too cautious. Both Skywrath Mage and Ancient Apparition need to hang back very, very far from the fights, and with two heroes that will die immediately if they push up too far, Not Today have to have a really strong front line, and
Looks like we
Juggernaut, he's
lost
great at
one.
outputting early damage, but he's not uber survivable. Prophet prefers to do his own thing, so do Not Today need to go for a big beef ball here? Do they need to pick up like a Bristleback or what?
I wouldn't. Not today, pick up a Bristleback? No, they need crowd control. They totally need crowd control. At this point, again, if they don't get anyone who can at least lock some of Not Today down or stop their maneuvering, then they're just not going to be able to take a fight. It's going to come down to as if they can get a good Ice Blast initiation off and Juggernaut can either blink in or whatnot and get his Omni, then yeah, the fight might go their way. But it's just the Skywrath Mage and the Prophet, they struggle a little bit up against the lineup. And you can see Pain Gaming, they're going for heroes that can exploit this right now. The Queen of Pain, if you don't have any lockdown, is a massive problem. The Slark, if you don't have any prop down lockdown, or the Anti-Mage
Radiant's
are
pick.
both massive problems. So if Pain Gaming go for either of those, or you could go for anything at this point, Not Today are going to struggle. So again, I think a Faceless Void could be good, a Beastmaster could be good here, something to give them a little bit more control.
Yeah, I worry about the Wyvern's impact here. Again, the Skywrath Mage has the silence. AA has that, you know,
10 seconds to
heal-stopping
go.
power of the Ice Blast, and well, Prophet can go and sprout the dragon up and slap her
5
down
seconds.
easily. So Not Today, to complete this draft, they're gonna be picking up a mid laner. OD was banned out against them. Invoker
Reserve
is banned out
time.
as well. Windrunner's still in the pool, but that seems very single target to me. I think they want to go for a big, beefy,
You'll
hard-to-kill mid
behold
laner,
the
and it will be the
marks.
Madness picked up.
Dire's pick.
I like it.
It's kind of one of those cheese Magnus Juggernaut combos, which I don't know if it's going to work this game. I think if, as far as lockdown goes, Magnus is a great hero to have, but who's he going to catch in that RP? At most two heroes. And if he gets the Tidehunter, then it's all worth it, but
10
he's
seconds to
really going to
go.
have his work cut out for him to get the stuns that he needs to get. Whereas
Five
a hero like
seconds.
Faceless Void doesn't rely on a 2 second, or what is it, like 1.5 second? I'm a
Reserve
little,
time.
okay, yeah, 2 second stun
Get it
at
together,
level.
Ted.
Come
I've
on, we'd never see Magnus get picked up. Come on.
never
But
played Magus in my life.
yeah, so a Faceless Void gives me a little bit more. I mean, of course, so too
10
does
seconds to
the
go.
Beast, but the Magnus could be perfect if they get
Five
a
seconds.
good
Imba
2 or 3
Spirit.
man RP. It's gonna be terrible if they don't. Because now, in Pain Gaming, they've got the Ember, another hero that will exploit the living hell out of a lack of control. So at this point, I really like Pain Gaming's lineup. I think they did a really good job at exploiting the weaknesses of not today's draft, but that is with a huge but, because not today's can come into a very strong mid game if Leo's style is on point. And considering how he was last game, that might not be a problem for them.
Yeah, Leo's style is very consistent. I don't think he's ever gotten unbelievably huge out of control, but he also hasn't really ever flopped as a mid laner. So it's a safe bet putting your eggs in his basket. And I don't know how I feel about the Ember Spirit last pick. I think it's very glass cannon. They have that Skywrath Silence ready to go at any time. So Ember, well, he could be stuck a little bit. Not today have fantastic burst damage. As soon as they get that silence off, as soon as they get any sort of stun or slow off, it's gonna be an absolute dead ember. So if he does go for that glass cannon build, he has to be very careful.
All right, I hate to put a little bit of a stop on that train of thought because what is this Magnus taunt?
Wait, what is it? Oh my god, it's so cute! He throws his little feces in the air.
What?
What an interesting game so
He's
far.
trying
This
to
is
be
gonna
like
be.
Skyrath. He's trying to fly.
This is gonna be a great game of Dota.
Oh, man, it's
God.
almost as good. It's better than the Shadow Fiend taunt. If he keeps doing that in mid lane, this is. I'm
Oh
rooting for
my
not today.
God, it's so freaking cute. He's got little fuzzy hoops. Oh, can I give an unofficial shout out to a sponsor that didn't sponsor this tournament?
Yeah.
Shout out to Mountain Dew Black Label, trying it for the first time. It's crazy good.
Oh, okay. You should have warned me about what kind of shadow. Okay, whatever.
I literally asked you. That is not an official sponsor.
Yeah, but
Oh
like,
man.
yeah, okay, whatever. We're not gonna talk about it. So this first rune, I mean, 20 seconds in, it looks like Pain Gaming aren't really opting for either rune. They've got a couple of men on the bottom lane, a couple on the top. What are you?
Magnus is still doing the feet thing.
Jeez.
I'm a mess.
I shouldn't have pointed out. I'm sorry, guys. Production value down the tube. So,
What have you done to me?
Leo style will get the first bounty rune, and it seems like, yes, he does tend to go for that bottle first on the Magnus, so it's going to help, but he's been pulled up a whole lot of regen, which is fantastic. He's going to have to go up against the Queen of Pain mid, not a matchup that typically favors the Magnus, but like a Dragon Knight, Magnus has a good long-range nuke, which should help him get that last hit in going, and maybe even get him up close and personal. Now, the IO is going to help Lenaro, so I don't think this Queen of Pain is going to be in any trouble. And actually, Jericho could be in some serious hurt here as he comes through. They've got a last right click coming through with the pick damage. It might be enough. Even the Tangle isn't quite healing him through. Okay, yes, it is. It's just barely keeping up with it. Level one Tangle does go up against the Shadow Strike very well, so able to stay alive, but very close to a first blood there.
Yeah, that's gonna be a consistent problem here. Lenaro isn't gonna have any trouble picking up the value point and blink, but free to max Shadow Strike after that, and the level 2 Shadow Strike will most certainly kill Skywrath Mage. He has zero base armor, he's got 600 HP, so a Shadow Strike in one or two hits is gonna be pretty miserable. Skywrath is gonna go YOLO into the jungle, get a free trip back to base after he buys out, so, well, he'll be back trying to help mid for a little bit, but King RD, the regen from this Wisp is gonna be fantastic.
Yeah, it's very important that he goes back too. He could have opened himself for King RD getting the first blood on him behind his own tier 1 tower. Also, King RD going back and scouting a little bit for the potential bottle coming through. They know that Magnus got quite a few last hits as Lenaro. He blinks really deep. Jericho, he's going to get under the Aegis in his tier 1. King Tika now has come in, being the trouble that he is. King RD now very low. One last hit from King Tika. Leo style is able to plunge his spear right into the heart of the ball of light. Lenaro now blinking up to the high ground, getting some high ground defense here. Not helping him out, though. He gets a kill on to Jericho, but will end up dropping himself Leo style with the level 2 Shockwave. Not too bad of a trade though for it not today to get that kill.
Yeah, I mean, I wasn't expecting it to go that way. I thought it would be a clean pick onto Jericho and a back off, but the deep blink doesn't end up paying off for the Queen of Pain.
Yep.
She now, oh god, Magnus is still taunting. I'm gonna lose my mind this game. He has his bottle here. He's gonna pick up an illusion rune and head back in. So Leo style, feeling good. Two kills to that little Magnus. Can he continue to go and pressure this?
Yeah, he can definitely pressure it. Lenaro doesn't quite have the bottle out to him just yet. Now he's bought it. This is a walking courier. So I'm kind of surprised that not today it doesn't have anyone moving in to try to get the snipe off. Typically, you'd see the Skywrath Mage Jericho go back, but I think this is really good positioning from Jubaloo. Not only is he getting some farm from the hard camp in the off lane, but also if Jericho were to move around that path, which is typical for him to take to go snipe off that bottle of crow, then he would have been able to scout it out. So meanwhile, Jericho's taken a huge amount of harass in this mid lane. He gets his first bottle charge canceled by an illusion from Leo Style. So far this lane, Leo Style has been on point. I really like the way he's been doing this, and able to keep up with a Queen of Pain is no hard, no easy task for a Magnus or any melee mid, that is. Very good, well played from Leo Style so far. Meanwhile, it seems King Tika has had to abandon the off lane. Nature's Prophet against the tri lane is notoriously difficult. However, he'll TP into Jubaloo. They've got the slow with the Ice Vortex and the last Arcane Bolt to come through. It doesn't even need it. It was just a straight right click to bring him down. Either way, they'll get a kill onto Jubaloo. Not too bad for this early game of not today.
Yeah, mid lane, Lunaro actually getting very low as well, looking for something to restock the bottle. We'll see, it is going to be an Invis rune, and there is a salve flying in on the EG courier, so that's always fun. Queen of Pain, she'll be feeling really healthy, sending the bottle back to base to get more regen. So Magnus is kind of wrecking her face early game, but Quap will eventually be able to rotate and get some crazy ganks. Speaking of rotating, up top there was almost a TP in from the AA, but immediately canceling it as 4DR. He's just deep here, creep cutting, going through. He's got the regen from the Wisp. Winter Wyvern chipping away damage at this tower too. Doridian defend this or what? Mid lane, Lunaro actually taking some more arcane bolts. One final shockwave will do it. Magnus is on fire here. Looks like the tower may end up being the sacrifice for this, but not today. They're getting exactly what they need to out of mid lane.
Yeah, and Leo Style is putting him right up close and personal with a fast blink dagger, even fast arcane boots, if that's what he wants to go for. Looks like he's been bottle crowing up to this point, but getting any of that really quickly is going to be great. Jericho, meanwhile, up on the top lane. This is to be expected. I mean, your Skywrath Mage is typically going to be fodder for the enemy carry if he goes to the off. And 4DR taking quite a bit of damage from the tower, so dropping pretty low. Jericho, I'm sorry, Leo Style might be able to come in and have something to say to this Ember Spirit, maybe give him a stern talking to, but it looks like he won't leave his mid lane. And as such, looks like they'll get away unscathed by anything else. But still, Pain Gaming have been able to put a fair amount of pressure on this top lane, and Jericho's certainly feeling it. Who isn't feeling it, though, is Benhaz on the bottom with the highest CS in the game. Net worth combating that of the Magnus has been doing so well. He almost gets a solo kill on Jubaloo in the bottom, but not quite level 6, so he can't follow up from that Blade Fury, and instead just backs off to continue farming creeps.
Magnus has arcane boots here. He's got basically everything needs to be successful. He has the bottle as well, and he's not going to be too far off from a blink if he continues to farm heroes like this. And now, well, Queen of Pain, she's sitting on her level 6. She does have that ult ready to fly. Magnus about a full level ahead of her. So if it comes down to a fight of the ults, okay, Jericho going deep. We'll get the silence off. He doesn't have the Mystic Flare. King Tekka on the backlines. We'll get the Sprout through the blink away. Looks like it will disjoint the arcane bolt flying at the Queen of Pain. And so now Queen of Pain will get back. There is going to be a rotation mid from King RD. Let's see if Dire want to find anything out of this. It looks like it might be just kind of a skirmish. Meanwhile, bot lane, Benhaz diving very, very deep. He'll get Searing Chained up under tower. He's burning down. He is going to try to spin himself away from this one. He's got the phase boots, so he's got the movement speed to get out freely. A lot of space being created around the map.
Yeah, and this is just keeping both teams at bay. I mean, you see a little bit of poking one way, a little bit of poking the other. 4DR has gone to the bottom, as said, so it's more or less they're trying to put some pressure onto Benhaz, which is very important considering how much he's gotten out of this bottom lane. You can see the net worth. 4DR is not that far behind, so keep this Ember Spirit somewhat farming. He naturally has a point of weakness that Benhaz ends up having as a point of strength coming out the mid game. So 4DR's got to make sure to mitigate that as much as possible by not falling behind in net worth, and he'll do so by putting pressure with the help of King RD on this bottom lane. However, they come through with a chilling touch. They'll now go out, silencing the 4DR. Lots of damage coming through. The attack speed's a little low, but they're still able to get him. King RD also getting annihilated off the face of the earth right here. Pain Gaming will know true pain as they drop two on the bottom lane. Meanwhile, Leo Style, that's not what you're supposed to do there.
Leo Style?
It's last hitting. You're supposed to auto attack cancel.
Leo Style.
Hail style, Magnus, no!
Well, he's a flashy player. And we'll see what he's able to get done, as he does hold on to his RP here. Oh. I've tried that taunt and accidentally RP'd, so at least he's one step better than I am. We're gonna see Ancient Apparition will be diving deep. Looks like Ancient Apparition will get pollen off by Lenara's ultimate. Not sure that was entirely needed, but I guess better safe than sorry. Now Ben has running for his life here. He does not have enough mana for the Omni Slash, so not able to turn and re-engage. There's gonna be a TP out, as Nature's Prophet will hop top and take advantage of the space that he's getting to push this tower. Magnus doing the same thing in the mid lane, so Juggernaut might be having a tough time bottom, and they may have to sack a tier 1, but probably worth it for the rest of the map pushing.
Yep. Nature's Prophet will hop on top and out-push the Quap. Aha, I was waiting so long to say that one. And I just ruined it. King Tika.
I really hate you.
We'll continue pushing down this tier 1 tower and might even be able to get it here. Doesn't seem like anyone's making a maneuver to stop this. Meanwhile, Pain looks like they want to try to counter push on the bottom lane, but Leo style, he TP's in. It feels like Pain know that he got in there, though, whether they saw the trees go away or whatnot. He is invisible, waiting to pull Lil' Kim back. He just needs the line, but waits a little too long. Lil' Kim's going to get the TP out, and they're not able to stop it. Or at least they didn't have any vision to stop it. They do end up defending their bottom tier 1 and will lose, or at least Pain Gaming will lose top tier 1 in the process. So at the moment, I mean, things are still going pretty well for Not Today at this early game. Pain Gaming, even though they're only a couple of kills behind, it definitely feels like they're getting outmaneuvered right now. And their heroes take a little bit more time to come into their own, especially after the lane. 40R didn't have that much trouble, but Leo style definitely ripped a new one on Lenaro, and that's going to push the Queen of Pain back quite a bit.
Yeah, it's going to be tower advantage sizably going the way of Not Today here at 9 minutes in the game. Now, KRD actually getting sprouted up. Not a whole lot to get out. It's going to be a tether back to 40R, and actually King Tekka may have bitten off way more than he can chew here. He's got no TP, he's got his eyes on the prize, wants to go on the wisp, but actually just gets a little bit greedy and ends up getting slammed by four heroes all at once. And well, Not Today. They can afford to lose that at this point, but they need to keep better track of where the heroes are.
Yeah, he saw the light at the end of the tunnel and unfortunately mistaken it for an IO, so wasn't able to quite get that kill. When yeah, I mean, Not Today, they probably shouldn't give away the kills like that. They have a lead, they might as well try to hold on to it, like, that's how you don't throw. But still, one kill at the moment isn't going to mean the end of the world. We're still only about 10.5 minutes into this game. The golden experience, in Not Today's favor by a decent margin, or at least more so gold. And their items are starting to come through. I mean, Leo style is getting very close to that blink dagger, whereas Lenaro, I mean, he's nowhere close to his item. It looks like he's got the Sage's Mask, so maybe we're going to be seeing an Orchid build up for him.
Oh, yeah.
Jubaloo, blink dagger. Okay, no, he was getting a magic wand delivered to him. At least he's got his arcane boots, so he can continue to farm out, but that blink dagger is quite a bit away.
Damn. What is Wisp smoke animation? It looks just like a big fart cloud.
That's
it is.
It's a wisp. How do you think he activates smoke? He ingests it and then spews it out in all directions. He has gotten himself an urn and a bottle, though, so his regen and his ability to sustain his allies is going to be pretty good.
They have King Tekka just kind of sitting here. It seems like he's wasting a little bit of time. Could just be hopping into the jungle to get some more reliable farm. Nature's Prophet, in terms of net worth, not rocking the top of the chart, sitting third, but still in a relatively good position. There's going to be some mass TPs mid, as maybe that looks like where they're going to start the party. We have a level 6 on each apparition. First Ice Blast of the game is ready to be thrown out. Omni Slash as well is online for the Juggernaut. Let's see where the party starts.
Nice ancient stack, too. It looks like Empower isn't quite the level it needs to be to quickly take this ancient stack, so he has to rely on his healing ward to keep him sustained through it. But still, though, they've got a whole lot of damage out, and this is a lot of gold in here. I mean, we're looking at about 600 to 700 gold that he gets just off of this stack alone, and at 12 minutes, that is a sizable advantage in GPM that you can pull out of that. So he's going to look to grab this stack, and there is a decent stack on the enemy team as well. Not looking too bad, but Magnus gets that blink dagger as noted from before. 12 minutes, Arcane's blink dagger. Leo style's on point, and maybe it gets worse. Ben has, remember, that Empower is incredibly powerful during the Omni Slash. If they can catch three, at least, heroes in the Omni, all three of them are guaranteed dead. So at the moment, looks like Not Today are going to look for that opening. So far, the only one in range is Lenara. Wouldn't it be that bad of a pickoff for them to get? They'd at least force a couple of rotations. The rest of Pain, though, are on the bottom lane. So it looks like, if anything, we're just going to have a clean trade of towers. Both teams fortifying, and both teams should get the hit.
Oh, yeah, Lenara hunting here. There's going to be a rotation in from Winter Wyvern as well, but not going to be enough. The deny comes through, so Quap is able to secure that gold. Doesn't really go in Not Today's favor. Down bottom, the tower will be slapped down by 40R. No one going in to deny that one, so Pain actually mitigating their losses from that engage and perhaps coming out on top, now opening up the Dire, or the Radiant Jungle, rather, to the Dire.
Yep, and the bottom lane, after getting that tier 1 tower, guess what King RD's now got? They pull through a couple of creep camps, and they give him his level 6 immediate tether. We might be seeing our first relocate coming in 13 and a half minutes, and boots of travel as well for 40R, so maximum split push potential. Hey, we'll buy back. Looks like they're going for the call into the mid lane. Lenaro getting cleaned up. They've got the Ravage, though. The Remnant, or the relocate, came in. 40R will move Remnant forward. They've got the Ice Blast, though. 40R may have bitten off a little more. He can chew. The Shockwave comes through. 40R taking a whole lot of damage. He's got a safety Remnant back in the mid lane, but is it really safe? It looks like it's just giving them a little bit of extra security. Pain, they've already lost 3. They may lose 4. Littlekin, they've got the Blade Fury through. The Shockwave catches in the tail end, and they get him down. So it looks like we'll have the TP back from 40R. Didn't die to the Ice Blast. It's still only level 1, but it forced him to go back. Now they got to be careful. If he Remnants back to this one, he might be in a bit of trouble. I think he's better than that, though. He won't go for the obviously over-aggressive play. Still, though, the first relocate and the first Ravage doesn't
not
really
so
net
hot
them all that much.
Yeah, it didn't really do a lot here, and Not Today. They're feeling really comfortable with their lead so far. It's only 14 minutes in the game. There's about a 5,000 net worth lead. It's not insurmountable by any means, but as long as Not Today continue to play safe, that's just going to skyrocket. Although Not Today's lineup doesn't scale well into the super, super late game. I think once we go to 50, 60 minutes, Ember will outcarry a Juggernaut. Skywrath Mage falls off around 30 minutes, or when anyone decides to build Magic Immunity, so... Not Today, they have a little bit of a timer going.
A little bit of a timer. I don't think it's really a problem for them unless it gets to the 45-minute mark and they haven't broken high ground yet. Like, if they have at least a tier 3 down, it's still anyone's game up to maybe 40, 50 minutes in. But it's not like we're looking at a hard cutoff in the next 10 minutes where they will just not be able to do anything. Benhaz, with Overpower, is brutally strong. The RP can come into its own, and Ice Blast is a really good scaling spell throughout the game, can make or break most team fights. So I think the only one that Not Today really will end up having as a liability come 30, 40 minutes in is going to be Jericho on the Skywrath Mage. But even he, if he 5 positions hard enough, will be able to have his impact by keeping vision up, by maybe getting a couple of sustain items, and then holding back, throwing out an Atos maybe every now and then. And that's a sizable impact for him to have. So, and I mean, one can't discount the silence as well. At this point, I don't think Not Today are struggling, or will struggle that much. And even if Pain can start to find their stride, Not Today have fantastic split push, they've got fantastic fight, and should be able to keep the aggression on throughout the fight, or throughout the game.
Pain Gaming, they're now cornered up here in this bottom half of the map. Not Today, they're not feeling a whole lot of map constraints. They can kind of go anywhere they want to, especially with that Nature's Prophet. What do you think Nature's Prophet needs to do to get the most out of his split push? Is Orchid the right build here?
Orchid's the right build for the farm, for the fighting. I mean, Orchid is so good against Pain Gaming. We mentioned their control is not great. Innately, I mean, Magnus is great, but his is on such a long cooldown that it's not entirely what you expect, but if you get Orchids, it's so good against 40R, it's so good against Lenaro, and it's incredible against Jubaloo. So you can get those Orchids off, you can win team fights easily as Leo style. They've got the silence, but the relocate back is going to save them. IO might be pretty much dead here. However, you can't quite discount him yet. Pain Gaming are there. Lenaro is close with the Invis Rune. They've also got Jubaloo. He's got the Ravage. They'll come through. Sonic Wave out. Jubaloo holding on. Just needs to wait for a little bit of time. Ravage now out. Leo style caught. Ben has in King Tika as well. The Wrath of Nature flies with a cold embrace, saving Jubaloo for now. Lenaro dropping pretty low, will blink into the trees, but they will go away very shortly. In comes a split shot. Ben has looking for that last click onto Lenaro. Can't quite find it, though. There he gets it. It's a crit. It's a kill. 40R is now going to chase the Remnant forward, but it's going to be the Blade Fury and a TP. They still get the kill. Jubaloo will find a killing spree, and it's a full wipe. Not today. Get creamed. And Pain Gaming bait out the IO and just demolished Not Today's Heroes.
That was absurd. Look at the overall just plummet in net worth. Zip zapping back down about 2,500 change off of that. And it's just going to be a nice, easy game for Pain. Yeah, Quaff is dead for the fourth time this game. She is going to be picking up her Yules. She's going to have a little bit more sustain in lane that way, but is this Pain Gaming just blasting the game wide open, or was that just a fumble from Not Today and they're going to pick it up and not do that again?
That was Pain Gaming blasting the game wide open. I mean, after that, 40R now second highest in the net worth, getting very close to that Battle Fury, which, I mean, makes that timer that you mentioned a little bit closer. I still don't think it's a huge cutoff anytime soon, but the more items this Ember gets, the harder it is to break high ground, which is incredibly important for Not Today to do very soon. Lenaro also finishing up that Yule Scepter. It wasn't an Orchid. It was instead a Yule's build-up, which I greatly agree with considering the Orchids coming out from Not Today. Io, he looks like he's going for the Glimmer Cape, so he'll have that pretty soon. Littlekin might be going for a Glimmer Cape himself, but is pretty poor right now. Still was able to get a little bit out of that fight, put himself ahead of the supports of Not Today. And of course, Jubaloo, is that his Blink Dagger coming out to him? No, but it's getting very close. So they got a whole lot out of that team fight. And Not Today, they didn't really get anything. I mean, Leo Styles got his Blink Force Staff. He had that before the fight, but none of them seem to have progressed really that much further than when we last saw them. Aside from maybe Ben Haz, who is still farming up a storm, but that was his first death, which is always a painful one.
All right, we'll see what's going to go down here. We're at 20 minutes in the game, a nice turning point where the early game powerhouses like the Skywrath Mage, like the early aggression Juggernaut, start to fall off a little bit. We are going to see a nice relocate here. There's going to be an Ice Blast. It will not be on the mark. Winter Wyvern, she's silenced up, but she's still alive for now. She's going to go for that Cold Embrace. The Treants whack it away, but do they have any sort of damage? Queen of Pain goes in with the Yules here. They're trying to get Ben Haz down. He's TPing away. Do they have anything to break? It looks like he will get away safely. Winter Wyvern keeps her life intact, and they force back a rotation from Not Today.
The only thing they have to stop a TP at that point is a Winter's Curse. I still think the cast goes through. Yeah, the cast does pierce spell immunity. See, people around it that no longer affects. But that was the only thing they could have canceled that TP with, and it looks like he wasn't quite close enough to get it off. So unfortunate that he didn't die there. But still, it's very important that Not Today don't lose Ben Haz in a situation like that, because he is nearly all of their net worth. I mean, a lot can be said about King Tika having some of their net worth and Leo Style having some of it, but Leo Style is only positioning. He's only an RP right now. And King Tika, I mean, an Orchid Drums isn't anything game breaking. So for the moment, all eyes are on Ben Haz, and it could be an issue as long as they keep him alive in a team fight and they give him an avenue to get the damage off. He'll be fine. But if Pain Gaming are able to outmaneuver him and just avoid his damage altogether, then Not Today are going to struggle to take the next couple of team fights and maybe even struggle to take the game.
Yeah, it's going to be a little bit of a fall off of momentum like you were talking about. Magnus now, he's sitting on 1,700 gold. Does he go for a refresher? Does he go for an Ags? Are we getting really funky here? What are we going to see out of this woolly mammoth?
I kind of want to see him go a little bit more teamfight. I mean, a refresher seems to be the obvious decision just because it's so good with the RP. As he goes in the bottom lane, we'll have to get Jubaloo back with the Skewer. The Ravage will fly, but don't quite have enough. The Orchid stops the Winter Wyvern from doing anything. The Relocate comes through, though, from King RD. They're able to bring down Jericho just because, I mean, it's a Skywrath Mage. King Tika will also fall, though. So even though they were able to catch, or Not Today were able to catch Jubaloo alone, he's just so damn tanky. And the rest of Pain Gaming were ready to follow up. That's the trouble right now with having going up against the Io and the Quap, is they can be anywhere, And yeah, now I'm starting to feel like refresher might be more and more important for Leo's style to get, considering 1 RP is just not going to be enough anymore.
Yeah, you need that reliable lockdown, because really, aside from the RP, what other stuns do you have? You have the cold feet proc from the AA, but that's not guaranteed by any means.
Your
You're going
answer
to get
is
the
none.
Atos. Yeah, well, the Atos on the Skywrath Mage will help things out whenever he's able to pick that up, if that's what he's going for. It looks like, actually, that's not going to be at the top of his priority list, as he will be going for a Veil of Discord instead.
Jubaloo's able to get an abs right now. Oh, Leo style! He forces forward for the Ravage, but can't quite get it off. Jubaloo dropping very low. They'll finally bring the watermelon down, slice him up, and serve him with dinner. But the rest of Pain Gaming are able to get away alive. Lilkin actually did drop as well. But, I mean, obviously you need something to chill that fresh watermelon on, so get the Winter Wyvern, but still, not today.
That was
beautiful,
man.
That's a decent fight to take. They'll move in for the Roshan and get themselves an Aegis, or at least try. There's not really any team fight ultimate aside from the Sonic Wave to really put some pressure on them, so they're going to get a Roshan. Unless Pain didn't go for it, they'll end up going in. Leostyle will push him back and stop the snatch, but they still get it off. Wait, no! Pain Gaming, they got the Roshan! Benhaz, though, will get a double kill off the back of it. They're looking for King RD. He's got no way out. Actually, he'll relocate. Is he going to try for the TP here? He's going to do it. I think he's going to do it. Come on. No, he didn't do it! Okay, yeah, he's dead. No, he did do it! He just did it way too late.
He did it very late. There was going to be the Ags tied. Shooting that big long range gush through. Did we talk about that pickup, or is that new?
Yeah, we talked about it. I was mentioning how incredibly fast he was able to pick it up despite having a slower blink dagger, but he didn't actually go for blink dagger, so that's why he was able to pick it up so fast, actually. Fun fact. So Ben Hazel moved forward with his newfound Aegis Immortality and triple, double, whatever kill. Gets a lot of damage on that tower. The healing ward keeping him very healthy. The tower will fall to Treants, and they don't even make an attempt to deny it. So not today. They're a little bit in the woods right now, but they find a decent path out of it. We'll see if they can actually take it, because the golden experience graphs are still in their favor. They dropped a little bit to the south for a short amount of time, all of, what, half a minute? But now we're back and not today's favor, and they just got to be sure they don't let five-man wipes happen like they did a couple fights ago. If it happens again, Pain Gaming, I think, take the game. But if not today, can just keep composure and split push and take good fights for them, then they should be fine.
Gareth Mage now has that Veil of Discord online. Not only will that amplify hit damage, it's going to amplify the Ancient Apparition, it's going to amplify whatever Magnus is throwing out. What a fantastic pickup for this lineup.
Yeah, it's at this point, the pickups are coming all over the place. I think Emporin 40R's Blink Battle Fury is really good to have, but on top of that, the 1200 gold that he's sitting on is really good as well. King RD did end up finishing the Glimmer Cape with Queen of Pain, Lenaro. Still holding on to that Yule, we're going to have the Aghanim Scepter out very soon. And Lilkin, though, I'm not quite sure what he's building. He's got himself the Staff of Wizardry. Could be going for really anything at this point. Maybe just grabbing a Yule's to have, or a Force Staff to help him get in position. He might walk in a little bit deep into not today's own reclaimed territory, though, as it comes Jericho out with the Arcane Bolt to silence. Lilkin could be in a lot of trouble. They just move right in for him, and they clean him down, chop him straight out of the air. Ben has Diffusal Blade, Manta is deadly. It's such a good item combination. The two items synergize so well. You can buy it really on any Agi carry, and it's really good. So King Tech will move forward, looking for King RD. He has the Orchid out, and King RD taking way too much damage. The Orchid burn should be enough, but last right click for some added insurance. They get the kill. Two down on Pain Gaming. 40R might look for a kill of his own, but he is backing off at the speed of sound.
Makes four pings at once, so they know exactly where the Queen of Pain is. They know what trajectory he blinked on. What is Lenaro doing? He's trying to go cut the wave, but this is kind of suicidal. He's got the TP. He's going to actually blink onto the high ground, go for the TP. The Ice Blast will not connect. He's able to get out. What a crazy cocky play from the 5-5 Queen of Pain, but it ends up paying off and making a little bit of space.
So what do you think about the Shadow Blade on Leo style?
I like it a lot. I think he needs to be a little bit sneaky. We've seen his blinks getting predicted by Pain, so the first time he shows off that Shadow Blade, if it hasn't already been scouted out, is gonna force Pain Gaming to play a little bit safer. They're gonna have to carry dust, they're gonna have to up their Sentry Ward game, and we'll see what they're really able to do with it. Their Sentry Ward game is actually pretty stellar in their own jungle and around the Roche Pit, but aside from that, Magnus could get a nice sneak up and just go straight for the RP of a lifetime.
I don't know. I really don't like this item. I figure more often, like, it helps him fight. I'll give him that. It's more a cop out, I think. It doesn't give him all that much aside from the invisibility and the attack speed. Well, really, it doesn't give you anything aside from invisibility and attack speed. Damage might be nice, but I don't know if that's the item he wanted. Is that the that's the item he needed? I think the build up into the refresher might have been a little bit better, or if he needed stats or something. Maybe just go Drums or Sanjinyasha to give you a little bit of extra movement speed or extra damage. Like, I don't like the Shadow Blade pickup because I don't think it synergizes well with his item pickups and with his team in general. But I could be wrong. I could be way off the mark, and I gotta give him credit because players know best, I suppose. But in the meantime, he will have the Shadow Blade done. Jericho has the Veil of Discord. I love this item. XD, not really all that much, but I mean, as an AA, he's known for being pretty poor. All around the map, though, looks like Leo style will be using that Shadow Blade. I guess this is why you get a Shadow Blade. For the instant initiation onto 40R, immediate silence to follow up. All right, I stand corrected. My bad. King RD now relocate in is going to put him at 7 seconds where they can just lay into him. It's like a cage match, except there's no match. It's only an IO getting annihilated. So
Gosh.
both IO and King RD will get taken down a peg. Pain Gaming losing quite a bit right there.
It's getting tough for Pain Gaming if you look at the overall net worth. It was a absolute demolish after that fight that went fantastic for Pain, but since then it's been a climb back up to 5,000 net worth, and I think it's only going to scale from there. King Tekka actually going in a little bit deep here. Lanaro is waiting, has that blink, has the Sonic Wave, just deciding when to cash out on that. There's going to be gushes from the high ground. Stomp and Ben has, who just balls to the wall, just chopping down this tier 3 tower without the rest of his team.
Aha, you're taking my balls to the wall. I like it. Ben has.
What?
That's my phrase.
Oh
Like,
God, I thought
I'm
you meant something
spreading it.
else.
Yes, I'm
Okay.
having an impact.
Okay. I'm gonna need a moment. Back
What?
to Dota. We're
What?
gonna have bottom lane. King Tech continuing to farm up. He's sitting on 2,600 gold. What's his next play here? Axe or Octarine or Scythe of Ice?
I don't know. I personally would like to see an Aghanim Scepter just because I like what it does to his ultimate, but a Scythe of Ice would be great to have against the Ember Spirit. But maybe they feel like they've got enough control. Still would help against someone like Jubaloo to have a little bit of extra lockdown and prevent something like the Ravage to come out. So yeah, I think I'd like to see a Scythe of Ice come out from him, but he could go Ags. I'd like that item as well. Still, though, we've got a smoke gank out from Pain Gaming. Looks like they might make their maneuver. A bottom push from Nott today. This is a familiar sight. The tier 2 will see some pressure, but they're going to come in straight on from the side. Lanaro, he's holding on to a Sonic Wave, waiting for the initiation to come through. He's got to be careful not to use it with the Winter's Curse. Initiate onto Ben has, but only locking him down. 40R, meanwhile, Silence is Littlekin. Cold Embrace himself. They'll get the RP onto 40R, which locks him in for the Omni Slash, dealing both to him and Io. 40R has to buy back. Jericho dropping pretty low. King Tekka opts for the BKB, and it's helping him out so much so far as Ben has. He ends up dropping down. There'll be the blink out, though, from the Magnus after the RP's down. Doesn't really have all that much. A Yule Scepter all out after the Orchid, as King Tekka will go in for the TP out. Nothing to stop it. There'll be a way. The Yule Scepter was already used. It's a 3 for 3, but a dieback from 40R. I don't think that was worth it at all for Pain Gaming. In fact, not today. It's a shallow victory, only about 600 to 700 gold in their advantage. But still, it's an advantage for them, and they force the buyback off 40R and send him down to fourth highest on the net worth.
Lanaro has picked up an ultimate orb off of the gold we got in that fight. So is it going to be a Scythe, a Lincoln's, or a Scotty?
For Lanaro?
Yeah. I think it could honestly be any of them. I think Lincoln's might be.
Lincolns.
Yeah,
I'm
well, with
thinking
Skywrath
Lincolns.
Mage not doing a whole lot, I'd like to just see a BKB nullifying Skywrath Mage completely in these fights, but, well, we'll have to see.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be a Lincolns because I feel like the Yule Scepter's great and all for dodging out the spells, but he really wants to be able to hold on to the Yules to cancel out like TPs from Not Today and lock down targets and send them out of the fight. So I feel like the Lincolns here might be the smart option for him. Also, it gives him plenty of stats and plenty of regen, which is something Queen of Pains typically need to think about coming around the 20 to 30 minute mark. Is now that they've got their spells out, they don't want to build too much into their spell usage. They want to start building into their own damage and their own ability to have a lasting impact in the fights. Because if they don't do that early enough, then come 35 to 40 minutes into the game, they're just a sonic wave. That's all they're good for in a fight. So they need to be very careful to buff up their right-click damage and really worry about what they can do. So I think it's smart for him to start thinking about that, as Ben has with the level 2 Diffusal Blade and the Basher, 3,200 gold, which means after this Aegis Immortality, probably going to be building in or finishing up the Abyssal Blade. Ben has is looking very strong and almost unstoppable with this Aegis Immortality. I think we're going to see a point where Not Today are just going to try to bull rush down the mid or the bottom. It looks like the line's being drawn on the bottom and take no prisoners as they look for a high ground push.
So Queen of Pain was once again just really, really deep over here. And I'm not sure whether that was a zoning move to make sure the Roche Pit wasn't the target of engage from Not Today, but it seems like Queen of Pain, she died with her ultimate on cooldown, or off cooldown rather. Why does she keep going so deep in these fights?
I can't answer that, honestly. I don't know what's going through her head. It looks like maybe she just wants to find a pick off in the back lines. A lot of squishy supports that sit in the back that might be really good for the kill. So, I mean, low-hanging fruit and all, but it looks like Not Today. Speaking of low-hanging fruit, they'll go into the tier 3 towers, as mentioned, trying to send the illusions forward to get a little bit of mana burn and stop any possible blinks or anything from Jubaloo, who doesn't have a blink, so I guess it's obvious that it's just for mana burn. But still, we have an Orc in the bottom lane. The Blink Dagger will get him away from any sort of aggression. However, Leostyle's there, waits out the Orc, and is able to get the Remnant out. So beautiful escape coming out from 4DR. The tier 3 bottom will still remain standing. The Force TP helping so much, keeping Not Today in a decent point in this game, but or sorry, Pain Gaming in a decent point in this game. But Ben Haz is still very strong, has the Abyssal Blade done, has the Agony or the Aegis of Immortal done. All he's got to do is get the buff up from the Magnus, and they just go right back in for another push.
See what's gonna happen here, as it seems like Pain Gaming could end up just hitting the final nail onto the coffin, but Not Today. I don't think they're gonna give up that easily. And I just got my teams backwards there, you know what I meant. Not Today. They're getting ready to cinch the victory.
You're not the only one getting the teams backward. A graphic designer, I just got him backwards. Seems to be backwards day, opposite day. If it's opposite day, it is an opposite day. I'll let you think about that one for a moment, as it looks like a possible smoke up from Pain, but it looks like maybe the last second they decide they don't want to do it. They're back up onto their high ground. They're kind of grouped up. No lanes are really pushing in, so if they smoke now, it won't be entirely obvious. There are no wards to scout them out or no one in Dire's jungle. Nothing to really give them any sort of vision, but they're going to not do it for now. Do they actually, is it on cooldown? Does any of them have a smoke? Don't have a smoke, and I would imagine maybe it's on. No, they've got one smoke, so I'm surprised they didn't do it there, but whatever the case, Ben has will go right up into the high ground, get a lot of damage on that tier 3 tower. Now we'll back off, but the tier 3 is done. All that damage was right useful. Looks like they're going to come through, though. The Nature's Prophet TP through. Jubaloo will turn around, get a little bit of wave clear out, but the racks are exposed. And now Not Today go for it. Ben has up on the high ground. They've got the Orc. And triple silence on the Jubaloo. The Cold Embrace will help him out, though. But the Ice Blast goes through. King RD is pretty much secured to be dead. And comes a split shot looking to try to clear out some of these creeps. And Anaro, he just blinks forward. King Tega's a little bit too deep, too fast, too furious. He's got buyback if he wants to use it. There is going to be a relocate, brings him further into the fight. But Io's already dead, so too is Jubaloo. 40 yards fighting up against Jericho, an easy fight for him, but Benhaz is the raid boss chopping Lenaro down. Still not able to get the kill though, not today, they lose three. They don't want to bring King Taka back in. They got what they came for. They got their melee racks, and now they back off. It looks like Benhaz didn't end up using the Aegis Immortality, but it should be going down in about a minute's time. So, all in all, a really good fight for Not Today to take. And they get themselves a Rax, which 37 minutes, they achieve the right timing to get the Rax and keep themselves from being subject to a hard countdown timer for Pain Gaming to just become unbeatable.
Ancient Apparition did also snag Lilkin's gem in that fight, so that's going to be a really important advantage to have. The AA might not be the best holder, as he does fall in these fights very quickly, but Pain Gaming can say goodbye to whatever defensive wards they have, as Not Today, they're just going to go in and start to massacre. That Abyssal from Jerkanaut we saw do so much work there, and that's going to be probably the death blow to Pain.
Not sure if it's a death blow yet, but we're getting very close. 40R still is buffing up his damage. He's got one Battle Fury and one Daedalus. So at this point, you can either go for another Battle Fury if you feel like they're going to group up together or you need a lot of counter push, or you can go for a second Daedalus. Personally, I think in this game, I'd go for the second Daedalus for the chance to one shot these supports. Jubaloo going in, Jericho dead. Lenaro and Lilkin are backing him up, though. If anyone looked to try to help out the Skywrath Mage, they'd be seeing as quick fate. So XD will move into the trees, looking to get himself out of there. He's got a gem, so going down would be the worst thing to happen. He's able to get the TP off in the meantime, though. So Pain, only get one. Not today. They're able to stop the bleeding quick enough to not lose too much there. However, they'll now move into the bottom lane. Looks like they want to try to put some pressure, but 40R is out of vision of the Ice Blast. Leo Style, though, is right on into this one. He notices his ball's blowing up, but it's not going to be enough to save him as he gets thrown further into the trees and brought down brutally by the Horn of the Magnus.
Is there a reason 40R hasn't opted to get out of here yet? Is he waiting till Not Today lose interest, or now he's going to take it back? It seems like he wasted a little bit of time. If he knew he wanted to get out, he could have just boots traveled out and wouldn't have had anything to stop him.
At this point, it's worth it to stay there just in case they back off and you can get a little bit of damage on their creeps. Like, at that point, you're in no real hurry to do anything. Sure. Farming efficiency is super important at this point in the game, but a couple of seconds of just watching and waiting and potentially getting a good initiation off or a solo pick off or even some free farm to push into a tier 2 would be incredibly beneficial to wait for, so this is not that bad. We will have to clear out the bottom wave though, as it's pushing in rapidly with those super melee creeps. So, Not Today now on the bottom lane. We'll run headlong into Pain Gaming's lineup. Benhaz doesn't quite know they're there, though. The Winter's Curse comes out. Benhaz not taking any damage. They actually hexed him while the Winter's Curse was going on. A little bit of bad stacking going on there. He'll come through with the Omni Slash. The Yule Scepter, though, protecting Lenaro, but the Diffusal Blade will bring him right back down to Earth. They knock him down, and now Lilkin, the Hex up, the Skewer back. They get another kill, 3-0. Up here on the top lane. They'll move back, but 40R is well enough away. Doesn't have to worry for now. But that was a beautiful initiation coming out from Pain Gaming, or from Not Today, to knock Pain Gaming down a peg and to open up their top racks for some pressure. They don't have the Aegis Immortality at the moment. They do still have a BKB 40 seconds cooldown, though.
Buyback on Lenaro might immediately get punished here. This could be a tether from the Wiz, gonna get Glimmercade up. Do they have vision? They do. There's gonna be a dust pop. They see the Queen of Pain. She's trying to blink back to the high ground. Looks like she will be able to get away for now, but that is way too close for comfort. Ember will be able to remnant out of the Mystic Flare from Skywrath Mage. And Jericho, very low mana right now, can't be spamming out spells like he wants to. Gonna be going in with that concussive shot. With that silence, getting the 40R. Just a little bit spooked, but for now I think Not Today have to back off. Their health pools aren't ideal, their mana pools are running dry. It's time to get back and reset. Not Today, great initiation in the top lane, but not able to seal the deal and push high ground in another lane yet.
Yeah, they came very close to being able to push high ground there. I think they had their opening, they tasted it, but the lack of an Aegis Immortality kind of hurts them a little bit. So luckily for them, the Aegis will be up in about 45 seconds to a minute. And once that's up, they can try to go for the Roche. However, the last Roche they had was easy. because the Tidehunter, Jubaloo, and Lilkin were dead. So there was no real way for Pain Gaming to stop that. But this Roshan is infinitely harder if everyone from Pain Gaming